Welcome back to PGA Chain Design. I found this fortune cookie. It has really interesting form, so try to duplicate it in Rhino. Here's how. So let me show you what I found to get the shape. Are you ready? Let's get started. You can find all kind of fortune cookie online and using the picture command to bring him in. So that's starting with the model. I'm going to creating a circle first for whatever size. This is a practice. We're not actually printing out, so don't worry about the size at this point. And I'm going to cut the opening roughly 1 point, one side from there, and mirror this to the other side. So using those two as my cutting object to trim over here. So this is the shape that we have. We also want to use this one to trim off this one and this one. Okay, so now we get the shape. This is actually curving a little bit. I'm going to turn on the control point on this one and move this up. And what we wanted to do is make this one curve. So I simply just want to rebuild this curve. And currently we got 2.1. We want to make it a degree 3. The minimum that we can have is 4 point. So this is what we are going to turn it into, and that's turned on the control point. So now I can kind of move it down something like this to fitting the profile better. In fact, I wanted to mirror that guy to the other side so I don't have to do it twice. Now we need to make all the parts kind of rounded, so I'm going to pick up those and using the fillet. Let's try 0.5 for this and this, and the same right here and right here. Okay, mine might be a little bit puffier. I can join those. Again, turn on the control point if you feel like you need to make them, you know, to adjust the shape, go ahead to do that. All right, so now we have this. We kind of study this profile is going to look like. Look like for me, it is more of a triangle over there. Let's draw a line starting from here, going up for whatever how tall you want, and that's snapping over here as a triangle looking things. And of course we are going to make things for more organic shape. This is way too sharp. So what I like to do is rebuild this curve one more time and maybe get a little bit more point to be something like this. Okay, and you can keep adjusting and see if that fit what you like. All right, so now we have this cross section over there, and we need to have some rail to play with. So let's go ahead to join everybody first. We are going to split this curve by this curve over there, so they become two half. I also need to split this guy right in the half with the point, and I want to split right at the midpoint over here. So you see this is rail one, this is rail two. Let's see what happened if we use a sweep two. Rail one, rail two, cross section, and we get something like this. It's not too bad. It's kind of a straight down a lot, but it's actually really close to the image like that. Okay, so I'm going to click OK, and let's take a look. If I mirror that to the other side, this is what we are going to get. And once you join it, that's one half, and of course you can mirror to the other side and could get the shape like this. Don't forget to join them. All right, so this is one way to do it. The other way that I'm looking at, I feel like by starting this, I feel like this is too bumpy over here. So I may need to have another one cross section in the middle to control the bumpiness. Maybe this is too bump over here. As you can see, right, this spot is kind of going down. But this is kind of really bump here. Right, so let's try the other way. We're gonna move this one to the side for the comparison. The second way I like to do, I might want to snap in somewhere about here, and kind of draw the profile that I like to have more control right in the center and finish at the end point over here. And you can adjust it more if you like it to be smoother. Okay, and as you can see on the perspective, it's snapping kind of a weird there. We need to have this curve is flat. So I'm going to, on my top view, project to C plane and delete the input there. To make sure we have a good intersect over there, I'm gonna draw a reference line. And the second curve, we are gonna to snapping into this point and kind of have it coming down something round like this. And again, you can adjust the curve and see if that fitting to your profile. And you can see it's kind of snapping something weird again. So coming into the right view, we wanted to do project to C plane. And we want to delete the input. All right, so those two I'm going to marking into the red color. As you can see, those are the two new curves that we create, and we need to have a curve that follow both this and this direction and somewhere in the middle. So we're going to use the curve front to view for this curve and this curve. And you will see this curve right here, let me turn it into the green color. Okay, with this curve, we can rebuild it because now it has so many points that's rebuilt into the 7 point right there. To creating this surface, we are going to use a curve network 1, 2, and 3, and we got this cross section over here. So now you can get something a little bit smoother. It's not bumped in the middle. So let's take a look. If we mirror this guy to the other side and we join those two, we also can mirror this guy one more time to the other side, and we'll get this shape by joining it. So let's turn on the other one that we have here, and we can do a comparison and see which shape that you like. But they are two different ways to make this fortune cookie shape. Lot more video of my secret 3D modeling tips and tricks is at the membership program. If you're interested in 3D modeling all kind of a different shape, welcome to join my membership. Thank you for watching. Please like and share my video, and I will see you next time.